In today's video, we're going to talk about running Cypress in command line, using Mocha Awesome reports, and also performing test retries in Cypress automation testing. So, first, to run Cypress in the background and to run Cypress tests in the background, for example, in a headless mode, you can use Cypress's CLI with the headless flag. Running tests in headless mode allows the test to execute without launching the full browser UI, making it ideal for continuous integration environments or background testing on your local machine. So in order to do this, typically what we do is we use npx cypress run, but instead, this will run all the tests in the E2E folder and output the results to the terminal. You can run Cypress headlessly using the headless command. So instead, you just simply add the headless flag when running Cypress run. And so this is what it would look like, npx cypress run dash dash headless. And then you can specify a browser for headless mode as well. So you can specify which browser Cypress should be used when running in headless mode, for example, Chrome, Firefox, or Electron browser, which is the default. And so this is what it will look like if you use the browser Chrome, Firefox, and Electron. So you can also run specific Cypress tests in headless mode. So if you want to run a specific test file or a subset of tests, you can use the spec flag, followed by the path to the test file. So this is what it will look like. npx cypress run headless spec is the fixture.cy.js file. So you're just running this file. And this is some more examples that you can use to run two files at once. This is another example to run all the files within your script, a folder. You can also enable screenshots on failed Cypress tests, so that once it fails, it takes a screenshot automatically for any failed test in the headless mode. These are saved in the Cypress screenshots folder by default. You can also enable video recording by default. Cypress records videos of tests in headless mode and saves them in the Cypress video folder. You can configure this in cypress.config.js. And so in this one, this is how you can configure it. You're going to enable video recording and screenshot captures on test failures. There's also another thing called Mocha Awesome Reports. And what this does is this basically creates a report based off of your headless runs. And so again, you would have to use a config file and you would use this command to install the package. And within your config file, you would have to set these following commands and these following things. And to run it in command line, you would use this command right here. There's also test retries. Cypress excels at testing complex systems. However, there are still behaviors that are hard to verify and make tests flaky and fail due to unpredictable conditions. Some common race conditions that could result in unreliable tests include animations, API calls, test server database availability, resource dependencies availability, network issues. With test retries, Cypress is able to retry failed tests to help detect test flakiness, and continuous integration build failures. By doing so, this will save your team valuable time and resources so you can focus on what matters most to you. And within your config file, you can determine how many retries you want to use. Okay, so I reran it and I found that actually you don't need to include the force tag and the save dev tag. So I ran it again without those two tags right here. And I just did npm install mochawesome, mochawesome-merge, mochawesome-report generator. And there we go. So we have this generated and we have this package installed now. So first, what we're going to do is we're going to show you how you can run Cypress using the headless mode in your command line. And so what this does is this avoids you from creating and opening up a new browser and having to run Cypress within that browser and so on. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to show you how you can do that. So what you'll actually have to do is you'll have to go to your command line here, and in your project, you'll just type npx cypress run dash dash headless. And that's all you have to do. For me, I'm going to specify that the browser we're using is Chrome. And with that, you can go ahead and run this. And you see, it's running 29 different tests right here. And it's basically going through all of these different tests that we have. For example, it went through getting started. So this number one right here, it'll go through all the folders of tests that we have. And it'll run through each one of them. You can also specify specific ones that we talked about. And I'm actually just going to stop this because this is running too much. So I'm actually going to say, hey, I don't want to run all of that. I want to run a specific one. So I'm going to use a specific tag. I'm going to say that I want to run Cypress-E2E. That's not right. I actually want to run Cypress-E2E-MyScripts. And I'm going to say I actually want to run idiom lucid or fixture. Let's say I want to run fixture.cy.js. I can type in this. And go ahead and press enter, and this will run it in the command line. And you see it's running it. It'll go through fixture. And it will run this in the command line. Now, some things that you can do, for example, if you want to make it so that it automatically takes video recordings and screenshots, some things that you can do is you can configure your file and your folder. So go ahead and go to cypress.config.js right here. Under this, you want to start configuring your project. And so what I would do is let's actually go to here, and I'm just going to add below it. So I'm going to go ahead and add a few things. So the first thing I'm going to say is, let's say video. I want to set video as true, so I'll set that as true, so I'll take a video whenever there's an issue. And I also want to set screenshots as true. Then what I'll have to do is I'll have to set screenshots as true. So let me see how I can do that. Basically, I'm just gonna go back and check that out. And I'll go ahead and I'll do, go under here, I'll type screenshot on run failure, and I'll set that equals to true. So that's true. And then I'll go ahead and finish that. There we go. I can save this, and let me run something else that I think will fail. So I'll run accessibility tests. So I didn't mean to do that, but I think that'll be fine. So now I'll run accessibility tests, and this one I know it's gonna fail. And so I'll let it run for a sec. And we see that we detected issues right here. And I can actually go ahead and stop this, but I'll actually let it finish running. But basically, we set in our config file saying that whenever there's an issue, we'll record a video and record a screenshot. And this by default will post into the videos folder right here and also the screenshot folder right here, which takes a screenshot of the issue that you had. Whereas the video folder will take a video of the issue that you had right here. So this is a very neat thing that you can do. Now, let me show you how we can use Much Awesome Reports as well, which is also a very convenient thing that you can use. So what I'll do is I'll actually go to our config file again, and this time what I'll say is I'll specify our reporter as Much Awesome, like that, and then I will basically have to do some settings for the reporter options right here, like that. And then I'll basically say that the report directory that we'll put it into is cypress-results, like that. And then we have the overwrite. We'll set that as false. And then what we'll do is instead, we'll use HTML reports and we'll say that we don't want any JSON reports. So JSON, we'll set that as equal to false. And then we'll have to put that there. And so this, we can go ahead and save. And now in order to run this in our command line, we have to use the commands for Mochawesome. So we can go ahead and do that. So for example, for me, if I want to use this, I just say npx cypress run, and then we'll say that we want to use the reporter Mochawesome, and we want to run a specific one. So let's say we want to run my scripts. Within the my scripts, I want to run specifically, I want to run, let's run something simple. So wait, go ahead, enter. And this will go ahead and finish running. And now once it's done running, it'll actually give you this little summary right here. And you can look at your reports in here for this awesome report. So it's an HTML file. So I'm gonna go ahead and copy the path and I'll open up a browser. And in the browser, I'll paste this HTML and then you can open it up and you can see the report, which is what it looks like. So this is a really convenient little tool that you can use to run your tests and look at your tests when you run it in headless mode. Now, finally, the last thing I'm going to do is I'm actually going to add something called retries. And retries is basically something that lets you run your test. Basically, by default, it makes your test repeat itself multiple times so that, for example, sometimes like if an API call isn't working, it'll retry it multiple times until it works. And this time, I'm going to set the default retry into 2. Before, it was no retries. So this time, it'll retry twice before actually saying it failed. So let me run something that I think will fail. So for example, this successfully test right here. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm actually going to pass. I'm going to run it using. I'm going to run it using the reporter. Mochawesome, and I'm not going to use a browser specification here, and this is what it'll look like. And now I'll go ahead and press enter, so give some time to run. So this time we know that this will have some failures, so it will retry multiple times to see how it does. So give it some time to run because for each of them, now it has to retry twice. And there we go, we finished running. It said most of them failed. Now I can go ahead and go to the reports right here and see what happens. So I'm gonna go ahead and save this, copy this path, open up another browser, paste this here, and here we go. So these are the errors that we had. And for each of them, it retried twice and it wasn't able to succeed. But yeah, if you found this video helpful, please give the videos a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for listening, and we look forward to seeing you next time.